Earth key? I'm lost.
Don't you remember, Santa? On C deck, where we are now, there was a big elevator behind the stairs, remember? And next to the elevator, there was a card reader with the Saturn symbol on it. And on A deck, on the door to the left, there was a keyhole with the Earth symbol on it, I think. So, the two keys that Jumpy has?
Should let us use the elevator and the door on A deck. Huh.
Yes, that's right.
All right, I got it. Let's get started then. What do you say we split into two teams? Lotus and I will search the Earth one, so you two can search Saturn, all right?
Sounds good. Then you guys should take this key. We have no idea what's on the other side of these, so don't go too far. Just search for 10 minutes and come back.
There's a card reader next to the left elevator.
Then let's try out the Saturn key card. Great! It looks like it's working now.
So like I've said before, I haven't played this game in quite a while, so I completely forget what's on the other side of this elevator.
Alright, now how do I call the elevator? Oh, it only has the upside down triangle on it.
I guess there's no up button. Well, we may as well try pushing this one.
It opened! Look, Jumpy!
Oh, sweet! It opened! Let's get going.
Wait!
What?
I'm not really, I just, oh gosh.
Well, we will be all alone in here.
Jumpy?
Huh? Oh, nothing. It's not important. Come on, let's go.
I said wait a minute.
Why?
Aren't you afraid, Jumpy?
Afraid of what?
Well, I've never, you know.
It's your first time?
I might get wet.
Hey, Faye.
What?
Down there. I get soaking wet.
Well, I mean, of course you would. That's the way it works. I mean, I've never heard of anyone getting soaking wet somewhere else.
That's true. You don't mind?
Mind what?
Getting wet.
Well, I don't know. I think I'd probably, you know, like it.
Gosh, Jumpy, you're so brave.
See, now I realize what June's talking about. She's talking about, like, the water.
Really? I mean, I kind of think any guy would do the same thing, you know? What happens, happens, right? I mean, if you get the chance, you've just got to go for it. That's what a man is supposed to do, I guess.
You're so cool, Jumpy. I really admire you.
That doesn't really seem like the sort of thing you ought to admire someone for.
I'm really scared.
Yeah, I mean, like you said, you've never done it before.
Yes, so I don't think I'll be able to last very long. And then it'll be over.
Over?
Yes, I'll go to heaven.
Heaven?
It feels kind of like you're floating in space, and your mind gets all fuzzy, like when you pass out. At least that's what I've heard from people who have experienced it.
Ah, yes, I've heard that too. Although, I don't think the same thing happens to guys.
What?
Huh?
But it would happen to men too, wouldn't it? It would happen to anyone. Once it gets into your body, the same thing happens to everyone.
Well, I mean, usually it doesn't go inside the man. I mean, generally.
Yes, it does. Well, eventually it will. It's not like you really have a choice. Your body will force you to swallow some of it. Eventually.
God.
What are you trying to do to me?
Nothing. I'm not going to do anything to you. I'm just saying that that's what happens. It's a psychological reaction to what you're experiencing.
Oh, is that so?
I know most men probably have larger lungs, but even then, I don't think you could hold your breath for 20 or even 10 minutes. Eventually, you'd have to breathe, and then the water would get into your lungs. Once that happens, your body won't be able to get oxygen anymore, and you'll start to feel that floaty feeling as you pass out.
Oh.
Ah, ha, 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 ha. Okay, well.
Yeah, you're right. You wouldn't last very long.
See?
Come to think of it, the lower floor, D-Deck, is completely underwater. An elevator heading to a submerged floor. That is pretty scary. Hey, wait a minute. This elevator came up from somewhere under us, right?
Well, yes, I guess it did. It didn't open right away. After you press the button, there was a motor noise like it was moving, and then it opened.
Yeah, exactly.
Yes.
So, take a look inside. It's not wet at all, is it? The walls and even the floor are totally dry.
Oh, you're right. They are.
Well, let's test it.
Test it?
Yeah, watch this. Now, I'll just put one foot inside the elevator and look over at the buttons. Oh, there's only two, E and C. All right, I'll push E.
See, I would have pushed C, because you think E would be below D, and...
I think I can hear it opening on E deck.
Okay, that's done.
Oh, okay.
Now press the button again. A single drop of water to be seen. See?
What does that mean? How can E deck be safe if the D deck is full of water?
Well, here's what I think. The elevator shaft and E deck must be watertight and separated from wherever the ship's been punctured. Here, let me show you.
I see. So is that why the ship hasn't sunk? The shape of the inside keeps it all from filling with water?
Yeah, I think that's what's going on. So I'm gonna go down and check it out. You stay here, all right?
But...
Come on, just do it, all right?
I'm coming with you!
Huh? Hey, wait! Oh, crap, it closed!
I can't just let you go alone, you know?
Ah, jeez. Normal. I'll knock it off. It's just like I thought. This part hasn't flooded. Come on, just look around. There's no water here.
You're right. It's not flooded at all.
See?
But there's a whole lot of water.
Yeah, right on top of us.
What's gonna happen if the ceiling breaks?
Well, we'd probably get really wet up there.
Huh?
At any rate, we should probably go back as soon as we can, once we're done looking around down here. Lotus and Santa might already be back.
Okay, good idea.
Now then. Iron bars. Well, we can't go over there.
Right.
Then maybe...
Well... It looks like there's a long straight hallway down this way.
Ooh, the number 6 door.
Something's written on the door at the end. Wait, is that...
Let's check.
I knew it!
This is a numbered door!
Yay!
But we can't do anything with only the two of us.
We better head back and let everyone know.
Yes.
Wait, what's this? Is this the map for E-Deck? I should take it with me. Huh, so you guys found door one. So now we've located two new doors. The 6 door and the 1 door.
It is interesting that E-Deck wasn't flooded.
Well, we don't really know if all of E-Deck is safe. We only checked the area around the elevator.
Even so, it's still very interesting.
You said the 6th door was there, right?
Yes.
And that means Zero planned all this out, even the sinking. That would have meant some pretty serious remodeling of the ship's interior.
That's pretty mind-blowing when you think about it.
Yeah, I wonder how long it took. I can't even imagine how much it must have cost.
It would have been a ton, that's for sure.
Well, that does go along with what Ace was saying. The most reasonable explanation would be that this was done by some organization with access to a whole lot of cash.
Also, his lips weren't moving. Or, at least, not when I looked.
Yes, it does make sense.
Yeah?
I don't think it's a very good idea to stay here.
Yeah, you're right. Ace and his team might be back already.
Well, Junpei and I should be able to open door one.
Huh? You guys leaving me behind?
Just kidding. All right, let's go.
Hey! Where the hell did you guys go?
Ah, boy.
Seven? What's wrong? What happened?
What the hell kind of question is that?
Snake is dead.
Oh.
He died, just as the ninth man did.
Oh my god, that's not true, is it?
We should make sure.
Yeah, right, we should.
Wait, not that way.
What?
I stuck a screwdriver in there to keep the door from closing all the way. It's not locked, so you can go in that way.
Where is he?
Shower room. Left side of the hallway. I put a broom in there too to keep the door open.
That means we can get in without going through the numbered door, right?
Yeah, that's right.
Then let's go. This wasn't open when we passed here before. Well, let's keep going.
Oh, it smells horrible.
Yeah, I would kind of imagine.
Ugh, yeah, this is pretty awful. I feel like I'm gonna puke.
Where is he? Where's Snake? There. June, you should stay here.
But...
Please, just do me a favor, okay? All right? I'm going in.
Just like Ace said, just like the ninth man, the detonator in his bracelet set off the bomb in his gut.
Oh god, the bone is coming out of his left arm.
Thanks for that detail.
It's definitely an open fracture.
Oh, the face. It's horrible.
Yeah, you can't even tell who it is.
But the clothes are...
No mistake about it. It's Snake.
Snake was probably murdered. Chances are he was killed the same way the ninth man was. It's pretty straightforward. Not that hard to figure out how they did it. First, the killers got Snake to authenticate on the red to open door three. Then they shoved him into it. Alone. And waited 9 seconds for the door to shut. Once that door shut, it was all over for Snake. But he didn't give up. He probably knew it wouldn't do him any good, but he probably ran into the shower room looking for the dead. It was a small chance, but it wasn't like he had anything to lose. Unfortunately, it didn't work. The detonator is only deactivated if everybody who authenticated when they went in uses the dead. Snake was the only one who went through the door, and then 81 seconds after he was shoved in, that happened.
I see. So that's what you meant by killers, huh? You need at least 3 people to open one of the numbered doors, including Snake. It wouldn't open for Snake and a single killer.
Yeah. That means we're looking at multiple perps here.
Well, just in case, I want to make sure. Let's say you're right. When do you think Snake was killed?
When we all split up to look for the parts for the Reds, I think. Right after that was when we noticed he was gone.
Then that means none of us have alibis. We were all off searching the rooms we'd been assigned, looking for those parts.
Yeah, that means anybody could be a killer.
Wait a minute. What are you talking about? How can you say that so casually? You're implying that one of us is a killer.
Technically, two of us.
Well, not just one of us. If I'm right, then at least two of us are murderers.
Why don't you calm down a bit, Seven? What are you going to gain by being so suspicious? That's what Zero wants, you know?
What Zero wants?
Exactly. This game was set up by Zero, wasn't it? Any game has a winner and loser. Whoever makes it through door 9 is a winner, and those who don't are the losers. Zero is trying to make us fight against one another for that victory.
Then you're saying that Zero is trying to split us up by making us fight each other?
Yes. That is why we can't let ourselves fall prey to suspicion. We have to trust one another and form a strong bond of friendship. Otherwise, we'll end up ensnared by Zero's manipulations.
Then does that mean that the person who killed Snake...
Yes. Almost certainly Zero himself. If there's anyone we should doubt, it should be Zero.
See, I find all this dialogue interesting, because I kind of know what happens. So, it's just interesting going through this again.
He masterminded this game, and kidnapped all of us. Doesn't it seem reasonable that he would have killed Snake as well?
Good question. If Zero killed Snake, then Zero is on the ship with us.
I'm not sure.
Something's still strange.
Hmm? What was that?
Well, I'm just wondering about one thing.
And what's that?
How can you be so sure that Zero's on this ship?
Really, Junpei? I confess I'm a little disappointed. Usually you're rather sharp. Isn't it obvious?
Wait, it is?
This ship.
Huh?
Zero said, this ship, several times when he addressed us. If he weren't here, he wouldn't say this ship, would he? He'd be saying something like that ship or the ship.
Oh, yeah, I guess that makes sense. If Zero's on the ship, where is he?
I think Zero is one of us.
So kind of a Danganronpa-esque theory here. That's crazy.
That's crazy. Isn't the ship going to sink in a few hours? If Zero was here with us, he'd be putting himself in danger. Why the hell would he do something like that? There's no motive.
You don't believe me.
Clover, I...
Clover, I understand what you're feeling. You don't feel that you can trust any of us, but you have to understand. The more we distrust one another, the further we fall into our true foe's trap. Zero was the one who did those horrible things to your brother. Do you want to let yourself be manipulated by someone who would do such a horrible thing?
I gotta say, Ace is being pretty deflective right now. It just makes him look a bit suspicious. And no, I'm not saying that knowing who killed Snake. Because I don't really remember that detail.
Thank you.
3 in the morning.
That means we have 3 hours left.
Then we need to move now. 7. Clover, I know how you feel, but you do understand that right now it's important we trust one another, don't you? We must go. We have very little time left.
Our next destination is Mercury.
But maybe you and June should check it out first and then report back to us.
All right. Let's go, June.
Right. Here it is.
I forgot we had the Mercury key card.
The Mercury card reader.
We're using the card 7 gave us, right?
Oh, okay. That's why I forgot. Because it just happened. Yeah, that makes sense. Totally.
Yeah.
I found it when we were checking out the shower room.
I think 7 said something like that. Anyway, let's see what happens. I guess the elevator works now.
Jumpy, I know it's only the two of us, but let's do our best.
What's with you all of a sudden?
Well, I'm happy we were put together.
You know it's just for searching E-Deck, right?
Even so, I'm glad I'm with you.
Oh, first we need to find out if the elevator comes up full of water.
Just like we did before.
Oh, here it is.
I knew it. It's not wet at all.
Let's go.
Yes. Look! Nearly all of the buttons are destroyed.
Yeah, only the seat and bottom button can be pushed.
We're on C-Deck right now, so the only one we can choose is bottom.
Yeah. Well, let's try it out. So this is the bottom deck. Hey, over there.
Ooh.
This is a numbered door.
This is the 8th one we found.
Oh, I wasn't keeping track. Yeah, let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yeah, we have seen all of them except for 9.
There were 2 numbered doors on B deck near the central staircase. They were doors 4 and 5.
And of course, Jinpei is now going to tell us all about them.
3 more in the large hospital room. Doors 3, 7, and 8.
And the door we found on E deck, and the door Lotus and Santa found on A deck. It was a 6 on the door on E deck, and a 1 on the door on A deck.
That means...
Do you think the next door we find?
Yeah, I think so. The next one's gonna be door 9.
Finally!
Yeah.
You don't look very happy about it, though.
It's not that. I just hope nothing goes wrong.
You're right. We should keep our fingers crossed.
Let's head back.
Okay.
1, 2, 3, 4. All right, 7 pieces. Just double-checking, but everyone wrote their code name and a door number they want, right?
Yes, just like you told us earlier.
Can't believe we're voting here.
We need to make the whole thing fair, blah-de-blah. This is a complicated plan, you know. Hurry it up, Mr. I have a brilliant idea. Yeah, quiet in the peanut gallery.
I was thinking the same thing.
All right, let's open these up. First one says, Ace requests door 1.
Yes, I do. Would you like me to explain why?
No, we don't have time for that. Sorry. Let's keep going. Next is Santa. He wants door 6. Yeah, that's what I wrote. Clover wants 1, Lotus wants 2, and 7 also wants 2.
Wait a minute. There's no way I'm going anywhere with the Elephant Man.
No, there'd be no point to the voting if we let people change their choices because of stuff like that.
But...
Just give it up, Lotus. It's not like I want to hang out with some exhibitionist grandma.
I am not an exhibitionist. I'm wearing clothes.
Barely.
So, last I checked, that's not a crime.
Maybe. But what about common decency? Nobody wants to have to look at a chick who looks like a half-naked raisin.
Jesus, Seven.
Oh, I'm gonna kill you!
Oh, not good.
Let go of me! I'm killing him!
Junpei, read the rest.
Right. June wants door 6.
Yes, I don't really have a reason. I just felt like it.
So this was everyone's vote. Ace and Clover requested door 1. Seven and Lotus requested door 2. Santa and June requested door 6. Then the door I should choose is... Okay, the last one is mine. I want to go through...
Okay, now it's this choice here that determines what ending you get, I believe. And there's a certain ending I want to get, since no one appears to be in the chat. So I'm just going to go ahead and look that up real quickly, see which door I need to pick. And yeah, so... Give me just a second here. It's not gonna work. All right, fine. Let's see. Okay, I cannot get the ending that I want, so that means, let's see. Which of these should I go for? Yeah, let's go with that one. So I'm gonna go ahead and pick door number 2.
My choice is door 2. Hey, wait a minute there. You cheating? Cheating? I'm asking if you changed your number after you heard what doors we wanted. How could I do that? I wrote it down on the paper earlier. Let me see that. Sure, here. I have 3 pieces of paper ready. Say.
You got lucky.
Alright. So we know who's going through door 2. It'll be me, Lotus, and Junpei. The only problem's the other 2 teams.
June and I want door 6.
Clover and I choose door 1.
That's not good. We can't open either of those doors with only 2 people.
Why don't Santa and June go into door 1 with Ace?
Huh?
Well...
Then what will you do, Clover?
I'll be waiting at the stairs. You guys are coming back here, right? That's what Seven was saying, wasn't it?
We aren't going to be split up permanently until we find door 9. We might get separated for a little while, but we'll see each other again. Otherwise, we won't be able to open door 9. And that's how the notary game works.
I'm sorry, but I just want to be by myself for a while. You understand, right?
All right. I'm going through door one. That all right with you, June?
Yes.
Well, we'll be going then.
Let's move too.
Yeah.
Right. Let's go.
I won't see June for a while, but this was my choice. I'm just going to have to suck it up. Seven said we'd all see each other again, and I'm going to believe that. The other group went to A-Deck to go through door one. Clover joined them. Our group is on our way too. We're heading to the bottom deck using the elevators. I wonder what we'll find down there.
I'm curious too, because even though I know what ending I'm going after, I don't know what's on the bottom deck.
We ready?
Yeah, anytime.
I'll go first. Let's go!
Where the hell is it this time?
I don't see it.
Oh, there it is. It's right there. It stopped.
Oh, yeah, it stopped.
Man, I'll never get used to that.
I'm not sure it's something I'd want to get used to.
Yeah, seriously.
We should finish this game before imminent death becomes a normal thing.
Damn right.
All right. This hallway's pretty short, but it's got five doors. Three on the left, and only one on the right.
Don't forget the last one at the end of the hall.
But it's got a metal plate over it, so I doubt we're gonna get anywhere that way.
All right, let's get started. I think we'd probably better split up. Is you okay with that?
Yes, no problem.
Sure thing.
And I'll take this first one.
I'll try the one next to it.
Well, I guess I'd better get started too.
Confinement room. Okay. Okay, well, that was